It's Vaughn, and welcome back to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim, ladies and gentlemen. In the last episode, we completed three contracts for Nazir. We have Miran Drujoe, we have Anoriath, and we have Deekus. And I don't know why I came back here without doing the other one, the main one that we're doing. We need to go to Delvin Mallory, who is in Riften. But oh well, we're here now. Let's go ahead and just turn these in, I guess. Maybe we'll even be lucky and get some more contracts. I don't think that's how it works. In fact, I already know it's not how it works. Why am I saying there's even a chance that that's how it works? I know that you have to do a lot of stuff before you can come back and do some stuff, so...
You smell like dead cat. Can I assume Miran Drujoe has been taken care of?
Yeah, you can, actually. So Miran Drujoe is dead.
Ah, well done, well done. Those caravanners can be an elusive bunch. Takes a fair bit of stalking to take one down. But then, that's half the fun, isn't it? Here's your payment. Well earned indeed.
So I think I've touched on this before, but man, if you want to get a lot of money, join the Dark Brotherhood, do these contracts. 400 gold a pop, and they're pretty easy, especially if you're playing a sneaky character, a silent character, an assassin character, a character that I normally play. Not this mage, fire-slinging Adrenok. No, that's actually really challenging, but hey, if you're a Thane, you get away with it. Maybe once, maybe more than once, but Anoriath is dead.
Ah. So the hunter came to know the fear of the hunted, hmm? Your payment, my friend. Well done.
Thanks, Nazir. You'll notice he's starting to give us the respect that we deserve. And finally, my friend, Deekus lies dead in a pool of his own blood. I was going to say in a pool, but then I realized, no, that was actually the ocean. We didn't even kill him in the ocean. Anyways, Deekus is dead.
Personally, I've always found Argonians to be incredibly unpredictable opponents, especially near water. In any event, nice work. Here's your payment.
Thanks, Nazir. Are there any more contracts?
Just one right now.
Oh!
Actually. I need you to eliminate an old woman named Agnes, a servant in Fort Greymoor.
Tell me about Agnes.
She's a maid, old and feeble. But with this contract, it's much more a matter of where than who. Your political affairs are your own, but any allegiance you may have in the ongoing war could very well affect your access to Fort Greymoor.
So what he means by that is, if you didn't know, there's a Civil War quest line in Skyrim. By far the worst. I'm not looking forward to doing that one. There's some nice moments, but overall it's the same garbage over and over and over and over again. So he's saying that if you're on the side, I believe it's an Imperial fort, because, you know, there's the Imperials and then there's the Stormcloaks, the true sons of Skyrim. If you're on the Imperial side, because I do believe it is an Imperial fort, you can just walk right in and kill Agnes a lot easier. However, if you're not, if you've started that and you're on the opposite side, obviously you have to fight your way through everybody. So that's interesting that they put that in there, but I'm not sure how it plays out for us since we haven't gotten involved with that just yet. Alright, see you later, Nazir.
Go on now.
Actually, surprised there was another contract. I guess that's why you should think before you speak, although I did think before I spoke, and I really thought that he wouldn't give us another one, but hey, because usually I don't do it like this. Usually I get the contracts, I go do the main quest and the contracts, and then return. I don't know why I returned without seeing Delvin Mallory first, but whatever. Let's move on. And before we move on, we're actually going to go to the College of Winterhold, because I definitely don't want to forget about this. And we're going to see if we can get anything in Illusion that can help us out. Now, there is actually a spell. I didn't mention this when I was talking about being a sneaky mage. There is actually a spell that makes your spells silent. And I don't know why I've known that, but I guess I just forgot about it. I guess I confused it with Muffle. So I'm not even sure who the Illusion person is, but we'll talk to everybody anyways just to see what we have available to us now that we've leveled up our skills quite a bit, especially Destruction. So
Jizargo is eager to hear how the scrolls are working.
Now, Jizargo is an apprentice, so he's not going to be able to teach us anything. Okay.
Jizargo awaits word of how well
Let's see. Tolfdir is Alteration.
I'm always available should you need me, Archer.
What have you got for sale, Tolfdir?
So you wish to master the arcane...
I do, yep, let's see. Still the same stuff, so that's unfortunate. I guess it's based on your actual skill level, which means we're still not going to be able to get much in the way of illusion. But we will see what they have to offer. I forget if we have stone flesh or oak flesh. I think we have oak flesh, but we haven't really been using it too much.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we'll hold off on buying anything unless it's a necessity, and we'll probably buy a bunch of illusion spells. I just forget who sells them.
I never would have suspected that the eye could be so dangerous.
Okay, you're an apprentice, Oddmund. Right, don't talk to me. I'm cooler than you. I'm the Archmage. You're an apprentice as well.
Could you help me with something?
Oh. Is this a quest or is this a miscellaneous quest? I forgot. I know what the quest is, but I just forget if it's actually a side quest. Because if it's not, we don't need to do it for the 100%. And it's cool, though, so we might just do it anyways, but...
I'm quite pleased that we're back.
Okay, you have nothing for me.
Perhaps we can go another few decades without a disaster.
Who is it?
That would be nice.
I'm totally blanking right now who does illusion. If anyone does illusion, it wasn't the woman that died, was it?
It's lies. All of it. I don't care what she told you. It's all lies.
Who are you talking about?
Feralda. Don't act like she didn't say anything. I know her, and I know what she's been up to.
What's your problem with Feralda?
My problem with her? She's the one who has a problem with me. She's threatened by me, by my skill as a wizard, by my elegance and posture, by my superior good looks. But she is not going to get the better of me. Oh no, I won't let it get to me one bit. That's what she's after. She's trying to undermine my confidence, make me doubt myself. Well, it won't work, I tell you.
Okay. Is that all you have
to
say?
Jeez.
I know that one guy sells conjuration. It's like, not this guy, it's a Finial Gestor or something like that. I know he sells conjuration. I know Feralda does destruction. I know that one weird chick, that one Breton, I think, does restoration. Tolfdir does alteration. So who's illusion? I guess they have to be in the Hall of Countenance because we looked at everybody else. It couldn't be Urak, could it? No, there's no way. He's too busy with books. Okay. Let's see what Feralda has to say. Let's see what Feralda has for sale, since we have leveled up a bit in destruction. It would be good to get something other than fire. So let's see what she has. Frostbite. No, we already have that. Ice Spike. I really don't like that spell. Oh, but that is Firebolt. That's the equivalent of Firebolt for ice. Right, and a spike of ice that does 25 points of frost damage to health and stamina. A blast of fire that does 31 points of damage. Targets on fire take extra damage. So yeah, this is just for damage. Although chain lightning sounds super, super cool, but it costs 1,000 gold. That could be good. We might just go with chain lightning since mages are going to be our toughest opponents. But let's see. Ice Spike, Ice Storm. A freezing whirlwind that does 40 points of frost damage per second to health and stamina. Oh, that's the thing that surrounds us. That's like ice cloak, right? And then we have lightning bolts. Oh, there we go. Yeah, let's just go with lightning bolt. Lightning cloak, lightning rune, and sparks. All right, let's compare lightning bolt and chain lightning. A bolt of lightning. Okay, so it costs. Oh, it doesn't tell you how much it costs to cast. Wow, alright, that sucks. A bolt of lightning that does 25 points of shock damage to health and half that to magicka. And it doesn't even tell us what the skill level is for this? Wow, it doesn't really give you any information at all. Okay, and this costs 1,000, so I'm assuming it costs a lot to cast with magicka. It's probably an adept. We'll go with chain lightning. That just sounds far cooler anyways. So let's go with that. And it's not going to cost too much to just get lightning bolt anyway. So we'll buy that as well. All right. And then we are done with you for all
right, then.
If you could tell me who sells freaking illusion.
We have survived difficult.
Is it you?
You can see me?
Of course I can.
Confound it all. I was quite sure I was invisible. Or at least transparent.
Ah, there we go. Wait! Oh, he does sell. Okay. Which are the best illusion spells?
Oh my, that's quite a difficult question. Never underestimate the ability to influence others. Whether they're friends or foes, they're almost all susceptible to illusion spells. They can turn the tide of a battle in a moment's notice. There are also spells that help in avoiding conflict altogether. Invisibility is tricky to master, but exceptionally useful.
Okay, well, what do you have for sale, friend?
So, you wish to master the arcane arts?
Yes, that's actually 100% my goal. Let me see what you have. Okay, so calm's not really going to help us at all. Clairvoyance, we already have. Courage isn't really going to help us at all either, because we don't ever use any followers. fear we already have, but someone was saying that's actually a good thing to use. I'm not sure how good that would be, but if we... Oh, no, not fear. Sorry. That's kind of okay, but still no. Fury is what they were talking about. So, like, if we can use a fury spell on our target and then they attack, like, a guard, ideally they would kill them, right? But I'm not sure if that's how it's going to work out. But here's the spell at least I was hoping to get, which is Muffle. You move more quietly for 180 seconds. And we can just, unless it's been patched, and I'm not sure if it has, we can just keep casting that over and over and over.
Farewell.
So, let's learn all of those spells that we just bought, which is going to be three. We have Chain Lightning, we have Lightning Bolt, and we have Muffle. All right, now let's go into Magic, and go into Illusion and Favorite Muffle, and we'll see if we can just spam that. And if we can, it's going to be like my previous Let's Plays, where I just jumped around in Oblivion nonstop to raise my acrobatics. We're going to be doing that with Muffle, because I remember that was the spell that you can do that with to raise your Illusion. Other than that, it's not really going to help us out too much. Okay, there's Fury. Yeah, so we just need Fury and Muffle, pretty much. And then Destruction, let's see. Chain Lightning is Adept. Okay, that's really good. Put that on Favorite. Obviously, we have a ton of stuff in our Favorites right now. It's going to be really convoluted. And then Lightning Bolt, we won't Favorite for now. We'll just see how powerful Chain Lightning is. So, obviously, that's going to be more of an AoE spell. So, let's put Muffle on both hands. I wonder if this increases it faster. Yeah, see, there you go. We don't need to be around any enemies or anything. We can just keep casting this. I wonder, like I said, if it matters that we're dual casting, if that raises it faster. I would assume so, but I could be dead wrong. Let's use it one more time. Yeah, look at that. All right, perfect. Okay, thank God they didn't patch that. Because that is kind of... I mean, that's the only spell that you can just, you know, spam and increase the skill. I'm not exactly sure. Okay, so we can kill Agnes... Or we can do that. I know we've been doing a lot of contracts, but I want to do this one simply because we got Chain Lightning and there's going to be a lot of targets in this place. So let's do it. So here's Fort Greymoor and here's the Western Watchtower outside of Whiterun. Let's go there. No one is quite sure why the Draugr walk the halls of Skyrim's burial crypts, but some believe they once served the dragons. And that's why they're cursed for an eternity. That's not what it said, but yeah. Look at that. Oh, I'm so happy. I'm so happy. We can just keep casting Muffle. Let's try one hand. And then the other hand. And then one hand like this. Might be better to do it this way. I'm not really sure. Who do we have over here? Hi.
Who you think I am and I don't care. Leave me alone.
I don't have time for this foolishness. Now come along quietly and we won't. Brother, I think she's telling the truth.
I'm not going anywhere. Now back off before I do something drastic.
He doesn't have the scar.
What?
You're right. We've made a mistake. Move along before that mouse gets into trouble.
Next time you're looking to pester someone, make sure it's the right person.
Wow, I've never seen this random encounter. So if you guys have no clue what's going on, every time you enter Whiterun, you get accosted by some Alakir warriors, right? That's what they're called, right? Yeah. And you can start a side quest, and they're looking for a Redguard woman. Apparently, there's a random encounter where they accost someone that is not that person.
Foreigners. What a nuisance.
What was all of that about?
They thought I was some other Red Guard woman. They just wouldn't leave me alone. I hope they get lost in the wilderness.
So very cool. Yeah, I never knew that.
Foreigner.
All right, so let's spam our Muffle spell as we make our way over to this fort. Now, like I said, I'm not sure if they're going to attack me right off the bat. They might because we can see them over there in the distance. I'm pretty sure they're Imperials. They might because we are, we're trespassing, right? Okay, so obviously also this is going to help us level up even faster. We've reached level 15. Let's go ahead and do that. Oh, right. There's not a spell. Oh man, I can already imagine all the people that have already commented this on the video. There's not a spell that makes your, spells silent. It's a perk in the illusion tree. So we'll explore that tree now. Let's put up health. Yeah. And let's go to illusion. Honestly, the thing that I can't wait for is conjuration. We could start doing that as well, just conjuring things in fights. But, you know, it's a lot to take in to try and weave all of this magic together, and it's going to make me die a lot, to be quite honest. So that's why I'm just focusing on one by one, but slowly I'm incorporating more schools of magic, right? So here we got illusion. Let's see. Here we have illusion, I should say. I've never even explored these perks. I mean, I may have done it once, just because I never play mages. So this is all very, very interesting to me. Right, so we've already seen that. We already know what that is. We have Animage. Illusion spells now work on higher level animals. That's going to be useless. An illusion spell works on higher level people. Now that's going to be good. Quiet casting. All spells you cast from any school of magic are silent to others. Oh my god. That sounds incredibly perfect. And also we're going to be able to get that pretty fast because illusion is something that we can increase very, very, very fast. So I think it's best to just start working on that. We'll put a point into novice illusion and then we'll start going up that tree there. What is hypnotic? Said that weird. What is hypnotic gaze? Calm spells now work on higher level opponents, cumulative with kindred mage and animage. Wow, illusion is awesome. Illusion is really awesome. I want to read all these. Fear spells work on higher level opponents. Yeah, we know that one. I'm assuming rage, same thing. And then master of the bind, illusion spells work on undead, daedra, and automatons. Not really going to be that great. And I don't think it makes sense that it would work on automatons considering they're... Well, I don't know. Are they sentient? Are automatons sentient? I think that's an oxymoron, an automatron being sentient. But I don't know, so I'm going to stop talking about it. Okay, so very cool. Very, very, very cool. All right. Now, let's walk a little bit further. Here's Fort Greymoor. Y'all care if I come in here? Actually, it would be really smart if we don't have Highborn right now. And we do... No, we do, actually. Okay, so first of all... Oh, bandits. Oh, never mind. Oh, I was wondering. I was like, I'm not just going to be able to walk right in there. That's not how it works. Okay, so let's use Highborn. And then let's switch over to Chain Lightning. And get everybody around in a circle. Oh, and also use or equip Unrelenting Force. There we go. Now, I want you guys to get together because I want to see this spell in action. So you come right here. Oh, it's a charge spell like that. I thought it was a spell that you hold. Oh, that's actually not that good. I mean, it's okay, but I thought it was a spell that you hold. It's actually one-hit killing a lot of people if they're just a base-level bandit. That's a nice little change of pace from all the fire that we've been doing. But we can't use Adrenox catchphrase, which is burn. I guess fry? Is that an alternative for shocks? Okay, we have a door to the right, or to the left, sorry. And let's switch back to muffle. And go into sneak. I think that's a good thing to do. Okay, we have Fort Greymoor Prison, but it's telling me to go into this one. Oh, this is gonna be so fun. I mean, not really fun. But it's gonna be nice. I don't have to worry about increasing a school of magic. I can just do the cheese way. And my philosophy with video games is I never use an exploit unless it's just something that I have to. And I've talked about this before, but like in Fallout 4, you know, it takes so long to increase companions and affinity that I just do the exploit where you get them all together and you constantly kill Dogmeat or down Dogmeat and then use a stim pack on him. Okay, looks like Agnes is through here, and obviously we just have free reign to kill her. Let's use Shock Bolt, although it doesn't... Oh, right, we didn't favorite. Okay, we can use Fireball to kill them. And it's good because we have free reign to kill her in this prison. Please, someone, do something. Oh, I'll do something. And what that something is going to... Actually, let's talk to you.
You fighter types are always underfoot. You want me to clean?
Oh, hold on.
Then scatter.
Hold on, buddy. I want you to clean and... Oh, whoa, whoa. Wow. Well, hubris. It's the fall of man. All right, well, let's try that again. I wrote that guy off, and then I got killed. What a surprise. Just imagine a door opening in front of you. A guy that looks like me is there. Okay, I was wondering where you're gonna come from, bud. Hold on. Two birds with one stone. Very, very nice. And I'm not gonna explore this location fully, even though I normally would, just because I freaking hate this type of place. I hate it so much. It's so boring. Everything looks the same. And I don't want to. I just really, really don't. All the forts actually usually don't have too many things inside of them. They might have skill books. Where's my muffle? Oh, we should put one thing in muffle, and then we should put the other in healing. Yeah, even though we're obviously going to have to get hit to make those points count. But It's better than nothing, right? And it looks like casting Muffle with one hand is increasing our level at the same rate, or still a fast rate, right? So let's increase our illusion one more time. You know you want to give it to me. What's it gonna take, baby? One more? Yeah. All right. And so we're done with that, but we're going to do the main quest now. I've given Astrid the amulet and sealed letter provided to me by Amon Motier. I'm to take the amulet to a fence named Delvin Mallory in the Riften Ratway to gain any information I can and sell it if Mallory is willing to buy. So, we're off to Riften, ladies and gents, and like I said, we could kill another two birds with one stone if we were to talk to Brynjolf and start our path on the Thieves Guild, which apparently we will do. I just don't know how... Adronach would justify being in the Thieves Guild. There's really nothing for him to gain there. I don't know. Maybe we'll talk about his alchemy prowess, since the alchemy is in the thieves, the thief tree or whatever, the thief section of the skill constellation, and it's more associated with thieves and potions and stuff like that. So maybe he joins the Thieves Guild to get some more acumen in the alchemy area, since we have been putting a lot of points into alchemy. Or we've been trying, at least. Okay, so I know for a fact there's a bunch of guys down here that we, want to kill. So we'll have to stop spamming that. I guess we'll just spam that, when we're not dealing with combat, obviously. But these guys are both going to attack me. So let's use Chain Lightning. Obviously, it's an adept level spell, so you can't just spam it. And it really doesn't do as much. Oh, wow, it launches them, though. Get fire arrow at the wall, bud. Nice job. And that's what you get. So we have Hunan Black Skeever, who doesn't have much. And we have... what was your name, sir? Droth. Nice name there. There's not really a point to use... There's not really a point for me to be using Chain Lightning right now. Unless we get into a point, or into an area... where there's just a lot of people. Are we supposed to drop down here? There's no lever or anything? Okay. Fine with me. These people are going to be pretty low leveled, I would imagine, so. Oh, an expert level lock. Okay. Okay, I can do it. Just have to give me a little leeway. Let me know where it is. Come on, is it over here? I'm going to stop at 35, so you have one last chance, lock. Okay, never mind then. Just a little tip, pretty much. That's trapped. Yep. If it's like an expert or... Oh, there's some oil on the ground. Any enemies for me to light on fire? Where are we going, actually? I don't think we're going the right way. But I do kind of like exploring the rat way, because we have G in the Fist. Oh! Forgot about that stuff. Who has the Gloves of the Pugilist, which are unique. Unarmed strikes do 10 additional damage. Sounds like something... Holly Hammerfist would like to use, huh? Whoa, what was that? Oh, bear traps, right, sorry. Sorry, I didn't give you the attention you deserved, bear traps. I just didn't see you, I guess that's the point, huh? Okay, so like I said, not sure if we're going the right way. There's an alchemy lab over there, but I think it's been too early. All right, not enough time has passed. Wow, there's traps all over the place that I'm activating, but not even realizing it. I'm just like, what's that guy, Mr. Magoo? I don't even know what that movie was about. But it's like some blind guy that just causes trouble and chaos for everybody else, but never gets in trouble or danger himself. Like, he always gets out of it. Hi, who are you? Oh, you're Lowlife. What a great name, Lowlife. Oh, wow. You're not so low if you can take multiple fireballs, though. There's a sexual joke there somewhere. What do we have here? Beggar, which is going to be pickpocket. Yeah. Probably the most useless skill that we're going to have on Adronach. At least one of the most useless skills. So we can hit this lever. Boom. Shortcut. Feels like Dark Souls. All right. Let's go into the Ragged Flagon. And I just realized now we're going to have to exit the long way. Although we did just make that shortcut. Now, let's take Muffle out. Cast that as we move over to our target.
Stay out of trouble. Mother's gonna be hell. Now you must be lost. Best you scurry off while you're able. The Ratway, well, it has a habit of swallowing up the uninvited.
The Dark Brotherhood requires your services.
Oh. Oh, I see. Well now, how is Astrid doing these days, huh? Tell her to stop by sometime.
where you'd have a drink. Catch up. But we could discuss that later, yeah? What does the Brotherhood need?
What can you tell me about this?
Let's see. Where, oh, where did you get this? No, don't answer. I don't want to know. This is an amulet of the Emperor's Elder Council, specially crafted for each member, worth a small fortune. Ain't something you give up lightly. Look, it ain't my business to tell the Dark Brotherhood its business, but if you killed a member of the Elder Council, you better believe.
Will you buy it?
Buy it? This? An Elder Council amulet? Oh, yes. Oh, yes, indeed. Wait just one moment. Here is a letter of credit, usable by Astrid only, for any service or item I can provide, as per our standard arrangement. You bring that back to your lovely mistress. With my regards.
She is lovely, right? She's married, though. I know. Sucks, dude, doesn't it? So we got the letter of credit. We can read that one. It's not sealed or anything like that. Let's read it, shall we? Astrid, let it be known that this letter is worth 15,000 septims, usable for any goods or services I may provide, as per our usual agreement. You want it? I can get it. Always yours. And it doesn't actually scroll down. Wow. That was my best Delvin Mallory impression. As you can tell, it was spot on, 100% perfect. Now, in my mind right now, I'm considering it is beneficial to spam Muffle all the time, but at the same time, it's going to take us longer to get places because I can't run. I have to, you know, walk and cast this. And I was thinking, like, of course I could, you know, do this off camera, but there is no off camera. I like my Let's Plays to be all-inclusive, or as all-inclusive as I can. This is just my thought process. You guys know me, my style of commentary is usually letting you know everything that's going on in my noggin. But, regardless, we need to report back to Astrid at the good old Dark Brotherhood Sanctuary. And we're actually really close to another level up. So, one tip I can give you guys right now, if you're new to Skyrim or if you haven't really delved too much into it, that's going to level us up right there, is that look up a list of how you can cheese all of the skills and just get your character to 81 legitimately. There are some that you can't really cheese and you have to shudder, legitimately do work to get to the max level, 100. But stuff like this, obviously you can just keep casting Muffle over and over and over and over. Let's put it into health, and let's go into illusion, and let's do animage. Illusion spells now work on higher level animals. Pretty garbage, but we're trying to get to quiet casting, so we need it, unfortunately. Boom. Yeah, we're not really going to be able to use that one, but hey, at least we have power over animals now. I just have to remember to use it. Oh, and I guess it would be smart to equip, like, a fear or something in the left hand, since we're not going to be able to use healing too much, but we can use fear on all of our enemies. Yeah, that would be cool. We can just go into straight chaos mode. Let's try that and just see how it works. So, fury. Creatures and people up to level 6 will attack anything nearby for 30 seconds. Cool beans.
Good, you're back. Well, what did Mallory have to say? Is the amulet authentic?
Yes, and specially made for members of the Elder Council.
The Elder Council? Oh, now that explains quite a bit. Motier, you naughty, naughty boy. Hiring the Dark Brotherhood to help you rise beyond your station. Delicious. Was Mallory willing to buy the amulet?
He was. Here's a letter of credit.
Splendid. Then we're ready to begin. Or, more specifically, you're ready to begin. After all, you're the one the Night Mother spoke to. Now then, I hope you have something nice to wear, because you're going to a wedding.
A wedding?
Well, more like the public reception. It should be a lovely affair. You'll mingle with the guests, eat some cake, stab the bride. Oh, yes. You've got to kill the bride at her wedding. And they say romance is dead.
You laying it on thick enough yet, Astrid? Who's the target?
Her name is Vittoria Vici.
She oversees the East Empire Company's business holdings in Solitude. The wedding is being held in that city, at the Temple of the Divines. Her death will cause an uproar, which is exactly what we want. Vici is likely to address her guests frequently, as is the wedding custom. Kill her when she does that, and I promise you a significant bonus. Now go, and give my best to the bride.
All right, so now we're getting into the good stuff.
Next time, brother.
We're going to end this episode here, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for watching. Things are getting pretty interesting, huh? I wonder if the same thing happens to Fury. Probably not. Let's drain our magic and just see. Make that fire angry. Let's go. It actually uses, like, no magic at all. So that's going to be a negative. Like I said, thanks so much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. I'll see y'all in the next episode. Bye-bye.